So as we often talk about here, memory chips are highly commoditized. Yes, companies like Micron love to tout their technological leadership over some of their peers, but at the end of the day, memory chips can largely be interchanged one for the other. And whenever you have a subscription that sort of cannibalizes that outright sale of a piece of hardware, the market has a really, really bad time trying to figure out what that means.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Chip Stock Investor. We're so happy that you're here. And if you haven't yet, please subscribe to the channel. Today, we're going to be talking about PureStorage. We first talked about PureStorage in June 2023. We'll link that video here on the screen as well as in our description. Go back and watch that video. That's a little bit more of a deep dive into what this company does. It's a little painful to watch, I will admit. We were still learning how to do this and I was a little more nervous, but the information is good. We covered PureStorage again, talking about it and HPE in the data center memory market. And PureStorage was one of our top chip stocks of 2024. We'll link both of those videos as well as in the description. Let's talk about whether or not PureStorage is still one of our top picks. Taking a look at this stock chart, we first started purchasing PureStorage in the later half of 2023. Let's maybe do a refresher on where this company fits into our semiconductor industry flow.
Yeah, that's right. It is a memory server or storage server maker. So it fits into tech equipment and devices, of course, primarily for data centers and enterprises, compute infrastructure. It also plays a bit in enterprise software. We'll talk about why that is here in a moment. But that sits sort of at the bottom of the industry cycle versus one of its suppliers like Micron, where PureStorage purchases its memory chips up there in the top left part of the industry flow. Micron, an integrated device manufacturer. So PureStorage, much more a play on the data center market, which of course is a hot topic these days because we'll wave our AI wand around as well, like everybody else. Data is a brand new commodity for this digital era. And especially when you're going to try to train and make use of AI, you need lots of your own proprietary information. So PureStorage, definitely a player in this market.
Let's talk about the three main parts of a computing system. First, we have the compute portion of the system. That's the semiconductors, the processors, the chips that do the number crunching, the logic of the computing system. You can think of companies like NVIDIA and AMD would fall into this category. And then networking, that manages and moves the information between different parts of the network. It's possibly between those logic chips from data storage to logic or into and out of the data center. Companies like Broadcom, Marvell, both specialize in these types of networking components. And then finally, storage, number three. That's where all of that data or information is stored, either in queue waiting for the processing or in long-term storage to be used later when needed. And companies like SK Hynix, Micron, Samsung, Western Digital are all makers of those storage components for the compute system.
So taking a look at just one of the chip suppliers for these storage servers, Micron, and we've talked a bit about Micron here the last couple of weeks. Micron is a top supplier of DRAM memory, and there's a brand new type of DRAM called HBM3E, high bandwidth memory. And these are basically 3D stacked chips for massive amounts of information that go into those things that NVIDIA makes to enable AI training. But here we're actually talking about not DRAM, but NAND, flash. This is for long-term storage. So DRAM, think of that like short-term memory that's kind of just waiting in queue to get processed. NAND flash is for long-term storage. And much like DRAM chips are stacked in a 3D architecture, and you have those little through silicon vias, those little metal interconnects that go through each chip layer to create high-density memory. Just like DRAM uses that architecture, it's not so dissimilar for NAND flash as well. Micron leading the way in NAND flash technology with its newest 232-layer flash memory chips. And as its name implies, Pure Storage is involved with this long-term storage memory market. And so it uses this NAND flash from companies like Micron, like Samsung, SK Hynix, and so on to build all flash-based memory. Now, this is important. If you haven't seen those videos we've done before on Pure Storage, or if you're not familiar with the company, Pure Storage is purely focused on NAND flash storage servers. They don't do any hard disk drives. That's older technology that uses mechanical components. Now, hard disk drives, HDDs, have done a fantastic job of continuing to scale up the amount of memory that can be crammed inside of them. They do lack in performance, in speed, in pulling memory out of long-term storage for use within a data center. And that's where Pure Storage has excelled in propelling this all-flash array. And even more than that, what has drawn us to Pure Storage, especially in the last 6 to 9 months, is we were looking for maybe a less cyclical place to stash some money other than our Micron stock. It seems Pure Storage has cracked the code with a subscription-based model. No matter how one of its enterprise customers needs long-term storage, Pure can deliver. It can be on-premises in like a private networked data center, or it could be in the public cloud. It doesn't matter. Pure Storage has these different storage servers available that can be purchased via subscription and a software stack built atop that. So as we often talk about here, memory chips are highly commoditized. Yes, companies like Micron love to tout their technological leadership over some of their peers, but at the end of the day, memory chips can largely be interchanged one for the other. And so there's not a lot of consistent pricing power depending on where you're at in the cycle. Pure Storage seems to have cracked the code a bit here with its subscription-based model that sort of smooths out the peaks and valleys in revenue. We'll discuss that more here in just a second. But first, before we talk about what the revenue looks like for Pure Storage versus some of its competitors, Kasey, tell us about the AI.
Yes, we have to add that here in the video. Pure Storage, of course, talking about it in their earnings calls as well. And CEO Charles Giancarlo had something to say about the competitive advantage of Pure Storage. He said that their strategy to consolidate data storage using a single operating and management environment for the majority of storage requirements makes more sense versus managing different and disparate system environments. He said that their direct flash reliability and economics continue to be unmatched, and customers appreciate the evergreen guarantee of no application downtime with system upgrades. And then he continues regarding AI. And this is a very important point, a very interesting point that the CEO made. He said customers are starting to realize that their fragmented data storage environment could significantly hinder the ability to leverage AI to unlock the full potential of their data. Current data storage environments inhibit AI deployments in two specific ways. First, the existing data storage arrays were selected to provide just enough performance for their primary function, leaving little performance left for AI access. And then second, that existing storage array is not networked, and that's limiting access to AI apps, not just provisioned directly on their primary compute stack. So ultimately, it comes down to these companies that need that access, need that compute power to their data, with it spread around in multiple places or in not a very efficient manner. It's just not cutting it in this environment. And when you think of a traditional data center and hard disk drives in general, that's where there's an issue. Hard disk drives are not very fast. It's very difficult to maybe pull that data quickly in an efficient manner so that the AI model can use that data to make predictions. And that's one of the most important benefits of flash memory. It's the speed.
And that's why Pure Storage has ultimately attacked this market, going from an all-flash product lineup. And some of their products have actually, over the years, as the technology has gotten more efficient, as manufacturing these NAND flash chips has gotten more efficient, they've actually reached parity with hard disk drive costs. So PureStorage is not alone in recognizing this. It has competitors that also provide NAND flash server arrays. Some very, very common names here, Dell, HPE, which is the one that we talked about in October in our last big video on PureStorage, Hitachi, IBM, NetApp, a big competitor here, even Supermicro Computer, even though Supermicro, obviously very well known for its AI compute servers, it also does have some servers that it builds for the memory and storage market as well. But there are some issues with business model. When you're building these servers, they tend to be cyclical. You can see that here in Dell's revenue over the years, just not a very high growth business and plenty of ups and downs along the way. Even Supermicro, up until it caught the NVIDIA tailwind here, especially the last couple of quarters, again, that's all the AI compute server, not really the memory servers propelling Supermicro. But you can see Supermicro was a growth business, but not a high growth business, and definitely some peaks and valleys in there. But we can compare that to PureStorage, which again, much of its revenue is now subscription based. So at this particular juncture, it still makes most of its sales from selling its NAND flash arrays outright. However, it's been increasingly layering in more subscription revenue, subscription access to its servers, as well as some software. And you can see some of the more consistent growth, still a bit of cyclicality, but more consistent growth overall for PureStorage since it went public just over a decade ago.
The last time we talked about PureStorage, we talked about this guidance for fiscal year 2024. You can see that they expected mid to high single digit growth year over year and an operating margin of 15.5%. What happened? You can see that their fiscal year 2024 revenue came in at $2.83 billion, just 3% year-over-year growth, and that operating margin was 16.2%, higher than what they expected.
So yeah, the revenue miss on the original guidance for mid to high single-digit growth, not a great thing, but company made up for that with the higher profit margin. And that's why we had the nice jump in stock price to kick off 2024. Noticed the nearly 50% gain so far this year, the first 3 months of 2024. And what's been happening is more and more customers are being drawn in by PureStorage's new subscription model for some of its newest products. And what ends up happening is if you sign a subscription, you realize the revenue from that over time, versus if you just make a sale of a server up front, you realize all the revenue up front. And so more of Pure's customers opted for the subscription versus purchasing a storage server up front, and thus the lower revenue growth, but higher adjusted profit margins. So more consistent growth expected, but a near-term headwind to the top line for the time being anyways. And you can see this reflected in some of the outlook assumptions for this next year, fiscal year 2025. They mention the FlashBlade, one of its newer products, now exceeding $2 billion in total sales since launch. And some of those new products just released within the last year, drawing in lots of new customers, the Evergreen One and Evergreen Flex, more than doubling in fiscal year 2024 and exceeding $400 million in revenue. And so more subscriptions versus outright server sales, lowering the growth last year, but that is starting to trickle down to growth in fiscal year 2025. They're expecting a return to double-digit revenue growth this year at the midpoint of the guidance, 10.5% revenue expansion this year.
Let's take a look at how that subscription model has progressed over the last couple of years. You can see fiscal 2020 is our first line item there at the bottom. Their subscriptions percentage of their total revenue was only 25%, but now it's 43% of their revenue in fiscal year 2024. As Nick mentioned, this subscription model becoming a bigger portion of the business. And I think everybody knows that we like this type of business model, hardware and software. That software makes for a very sticky customer.
Absolutely. And we like to purchase things with the intention of owning the stock for the indefinite future, if everything works out perfectly. So that said, like you mentioned, we started buying second half of 2023, called this You called this in particular one of your favorite stocks for 2024. So far, so good, Kasey. Well done. So let's do a valuation update at this point. As we record, this is the stock price pre-market April 1st, 2024, based on the stock price market close Thursday, March 28th, before the three-day holiday weekend, about $52 per share, or a market cap of almost $16.5 billion. Pure Storage trades for about 90 times current year expected earnings, or 33 times on an adjusted basis, and about 30 times current year expected free cash flow. Lots of cash, very little debt. So that's fantastic. All the boxes check off there. Valuation is a bit high though, especially for a company that it's not highly profitable yet. This is still a pretty young business. So obviously the market expecting lots of profitable growth in the years ahead. Let's do a reverse discount cash flow to roughly figure out what the market is expecting for that $52 per share stock price. We think free cash flow per share growth of about 12% for the next 5 years, and then about a 6% terminal growth rate after that. Discount rate of 10% gets us to that $52 stock price. We think that's roughly what the market is expecting here for this particular company. So the question now becomes, is that a reasonable expectation if you wanted to buy Pure Storage stock right now for the long term?
I think most who've watched our videos know, especially in the last 6 months, I really like this company. I like Pure Storage. They have the best color scheme in their presentations, which is always, of course, an important factor that I consider sarcasm. But really, it's a great business model. They are continuing to improve on the business model and make for very long-term customers. And so for us, I really, truly believe that this is a long-term hold for us. I think it's a good DCA candidate. What do you think?
Yeah, it definitely, when we did the video in December outlining our favorite picks at that time for the new year, it seemed like Pure Storage was on the value end of the spectrum. What had happened is they had missed the revenue guidance. The market had this temporary freak out, like it often does with these companies that have a mix of outright hardware sales and subscription. And whenever you have a subscription that sort of cannibalizes that outright sale of a piece of hardware, the market has a really, really bad time trying to figure out what that means. And so the stock price had declined at the end of the year and really had discounted what was still a fantastic business that was still sitting on ample growth. And then, of course, we get the guidance for fiscal year 2025. Lo and behold, the growth story is far from over. And of course, AI, this is not purely an AI stock. A lot of companies just need high-performance data storage for a lot of other applications besides AI. But the use case is obviously there, especially for Pure's higher-end servers. I think modest sales growth, maybe in the mid to high single-digit percentages, paired with profit margin expansion in the coming years as the company continues to mature, is a very reasonable expectation. So I agree with you. I think this is fairly valued and will continue to sit on our watch list going forward. Maybe one that we nibble on here and there via some sort of dollar cost average plan as we review what we're buying each month.
All right, that's a wrap on our take on Pure Storage. Make sure you stay tuned, hit that subscribe button and have notifications turned on. And of course, you can always check out our membership here on YouTube or over on our Ko-fi channel to get access to our Discord membership and all of our published manuals. And if you're not into that, check out our Ko-fi shop where we have all of those PDFs available for purchase. Stay tuned. We still have our video on Zscaler coming up.
And later this week, we are doing another industry manual where we do a deeper dive into how an industry operates and all of the stocks that participate in that market. This one will be on wafer fab and packaging equipment, which a year ago we released an entire index of publicly traded stocks on, but that has been completely buried. It's time to do a refresh and turn that into a full-blown manual that hopefully you'll be able to make good use of as you do your own due diligence on that exciting part of the semiconductor industry.
All right. We'll see you all again very soon here at Chip Stock Investor.